Speaking of Treacle here, she is new to the political scene, but she's very well versed, highly educated, and highly motivated. And it's my honor to introduce our next state representative from District 175, Ms. Treacle.
District 175, and that covers Brooks County, all of Brooks County, part of Lowndes, that's that west side of Lowndes, and the eastern portion of Thomas County. Okay, so that's quite a few people there. So I want to tell you a little bit about myself, and I'm not going to be before you long. First of all, I'm an educator, and I'm an Army veteran. And so I enjoy serving my country. Veterans in the house as well. Well, as I said, I'm an educator. I taught biology and physical science for 10 years, and I'm also currently an instructional coach at Lowndes High School. And I hold a doctorate in adult and career education because I believe that we need to actually bridge the gap from students from high school into higher education. So having said that, I want to first tell you that education is the foundation of prosperity for all things. All things. And so that's a key area that we need to work on. And those are areas that all students need to have that equal opportunity and equal access to a quality education. So, but the thing about it is when our students graduated, they've gotten that education, they need to make sure they maximize on that. So I want to talk to you about the broken bootstraps, what I call the broken bootstraps of District 175. And we'll start first with, I'll lead off on something that our future Congressman Ring said was in terms of affordable and quality health care, the Medicaid expansion. We've worked at $3 billion a year that could go towards expanding Medicaid to 500,000 Georgians. But because our state legislature refused to accept it, we don't get that. So there are people that are uninsured, there are people that fall into a coverage gap. So we need to work on that, and that's going to be a big thing, as well as Stacey Abrams and other legislators, other people who are running this year. Also looking at real pay.
People need to have a living wage. Because if you work 40 hours a week, you shouldn't have to struggle. You shouldn't have to struggle. There are people who are struggling working several, more than one job, and they're not making ends meet. And then looking at, and that's one of our broken bootstraps, then looking at public transit. Because of where we live at, people shouldn't be geographically isolated from the educational opportunities that we have to offer in the district, nor the
job opportunities. So we look across our district, we have several different educational institutions like VSU, Wiregrass Technical College, Thomasville University, and the Technical College is already also over there, Georgia Military College. But if you don't have transportation, you can't get access to those things. So they say, well, go get some certification. Well, how am I going to get there? You can only ride a bicycle to so many schools and only to so many jobs. So we need to work on that.
Our call to duty and what we have to do is because Georgia's a great state for building business. But because we did what we thought, you know, it's a good state for doing business. But the thing about it is that we have to build our people first. Because when we build our people, we build business and a better Georgia. And that's what we have to work on. Because if we want change, it's going to take all of us. If we want the blue wave, it's going to take all of us. So I'm calling you out to help us. Because it's not about me, it's about you. So let's turn Georgia blue.
Yeah!